think we'll direct this first one to Father Rodriguez. Father, two people have asked about Our Lady of Fatima's saying that to begin the third secret in Portugal, the dogma of the faith will always be preserved. The question that several people asked, and one has termed it this way, has Portugal apostatized with its acceptance of homosexuality? Is the dogma of the faith preserved in Portugal? And if not, what are we to make of Our Lady's, Our Lady of Fatima's words?
No, I mean, again, it's a very good question, because I'll be completely honest with you. I'm not sure. I mean, there have been different theories that have been put out. I mean, there was one theory that spoke about, I don't know how many of you are familiar with the history of the Diocese of Campos in Brazil. But anyway, one theory that I read was that, you know, kind of saying, look, Brazil is like a colony of Portugal, and because there was this one unique diocese, really was a unique diocese in the entire world, that when all of the changes took place after the Second Vatican Council, that in that diocese, the traditional Latin Mass was preserved, and it's been preserved really unto this day. So it's kind of a really unique situation. So I did read one, like I say, theory that explained it that way, saying that, you know, like the true Catholic worship and the true Catholic doctrine has been preserved there, and sort of kind of like extending that as in Portugal. But, I mean, other than that theory that I've heard, I mean, quite frankly, I'm not sure. I mean, do we know, Kevin, if Father Gruner ever said anything about that? Because I'm not aware of it, but do we know, Dave, maybe? But Dave?
There are a couple of things. I'm going to throw a big...
You have to turn on the microphone, Dave.
I am going to throw a little bit of a hairball into this, but I think it's humility for us. When she says those words, we don't have the proper interpretation, because that's the third secret, and those are the words that are kept hidden from us. So it could be, not that the entire Portugal country, all the Catholics there, it could be that there's a small flock of faithful, 10 Catholics that hold the faith and live in Portugal, and the words of Our Lady would still ring true. So there's one possibility, again, but we don't know. The other possibility, and we know that in the message of Fatima, in this great secret, Our Lady is giving conditional prophecies and definite prophecies. The definite prophecy is, in the end, my Immaculate Heart will triumph. The Pope will consecrate Russia, so no doubt about that. But there's all those, if you remember, those ifs. If they obey my requests, they'll be, if they don't, they'll be this. There's nothing to say that the words that followed weren't a conditional prophecy. The dogma of the faith will always remain in Portugal if the Portuguese bishops don't change the Mass and the dogma of the faith, for example. And then she can, and in other places, if they do change it, it will be lost. We have no idea. So even this assumption that some people have that, well, like somehow Portugal would remain out of the apostasy, the assumptions are being made. And so we have to, I think, have a lot of humility and realize we don't know the words that followed, and we don't have the proper interpretation, and we do have to remain open to different possibilities until that third secret is revealed.